Hello. In the second video, we will explore time division multiplexing. As we have discussed in the previous video, we have two DC signals and we have two AC signals of the frequency 1 kHz and 2 kHz. Amplitude of all these signals we can vary. Usually it is from minus 5 volt to plus 5 volt. So let us see. The DC voltage this is a fully anti-clockwise movement, and we can see the minimum voltage is minus 5.38. I am increasing it, it will goes to zero and then it goes to positive side, and at fully clockwise movement it will reach to 5.43 volt. So similarly we can verify with the DC signal 2. The highest voltage is same and I am varying it to the negative side anti-clockwise, that is minus 5.41. In order to observe analog signal, sinusoidal signal with the frequency of 1 kHz, we will connect the ground. And then we will connect the positive to the knob off. And here we can see the 1 kHz sine wave, and this is the minimum voltage. And it is increasing, and it attains maximum value, that is somewhere nearby 10.8 or 9 volt, peak to peak volt. At the same time, when I connect this to the second signal, that is 2 kHz frequency, and similar voltage variation we can achieve by the variation of knob. So let us see the multiplexing of two AC signal. So 1 kHz I will connect to channel 0 and 2 kHz I will connect to channel 1, and the output is available at test point number 15, and this is a multiplexing of two signal. If you want to see input and output together to observe I am connecting the ground of the second channel and positive of the second channel CRO connecting to the 1 kHz signal. Keep CRO in dual mode. Actually